Hey, what's up, guys? Glad you could join us again. Today, we're gonna go over how to analyze a deal when you really don't have the data. Let's say you don't have the trailing 12s. You don't know what the rents are. And let's say you found a building that you think you wanna put an offer on, and you don't know how to even determine the value. Well, you gotta kind of fill in the blanks. So today, we're gonna tell you how to do it, real simple, on how you analyze the deal very quickly, determine it's even worth putting an offer on, even when it's off market, all right? But here's some of the key things you have to have, and you can find most of this information in CoStar, which is a little expensive, but that breaks down the market, the cap rates, everything. But Rent-A-Meter, that'll help you find the average rent, which is online and it's free, and there's a few other different software programs online that you can utilize. But let's do this one project. So one of the key things you need to know is when you start, what's the number of doors do you have, right? We gotta have that. The other thing is you need, in those doors, you need to know the makeup. The makeup is like, you know, is it ones, twos, or three bedrooms, right? That's what we're trying to figure out. Also, you know, is it on a boiler? Some of that's not 100% necessary, but you kind of need to know, is it separate utilities or boiler, right? That's all. But these are the key things. And then once you find that, you need to know the average rent. Now, once you have these three things, you can begin to solve the problem. So number one, how many doors? In this example, we'll say 100 units. All right, for this deal. And then we'll say on this one, the average makeup is all two bedrooms. All right, we're gonna say it's two bedrooms. And the average rent is let's just say $900 a month. Okay, that's easy. Now next, once we do that, we wanna find out what the annual rent is, what the effective gross rent is. So you simply take the 100 units times the average rent, which is $900. And you're gonna have an income of $90,000 a month. Then you take that number and multiply it times 12 because you wanna get the annual rent. So your annual rent is going to be $1,080,000, right? That's your annual rent. That's what you need there. Now, next, some people are like, man, I gotta have the, what is it? All the expenses, I need the trailing 12. No, you don't. You don't need all that. You do to get a serious number, but just to get an idea where you're at, you simply just use an expense ratio. Well, some of you are like, well, what is that? Let's go over here and flip over. So most of the time when you use an expense ratio, there's the 50-50, there's the 60-40, and the 40-60. I may get the numbers wrong, but for the most part, we'll stick to the front part. What we're saying is, this first section, all of that goes to expenses. And then this portion, all of that is your, should be your NOI, all right? So you got that? So if we use a 50-50 expense ratio, meaning 50 goes to expenses, whatever's left, 50% of that should be your NOI, okay? So in this particular case, remember we said we had $1 million. And for me, when do you use it? Let me step back for a second. When do you use this? 50-50, I just use a conservative model. 60-40, that's when I think, you know, the owner's paying the boiler and all these other expenses. 40-60, I use this ratio when I believe I have higher end rents, because the higher the rents go, your expense ratio will drop. Because for example, let's say your average rent per unit averages $5,900 a year. Well, if it's you getting $700 a month in rent, well, that expense ratio is gonna be high. But if you're getting $1,000 rent, the expense ratio drops, all right? So on this, we'll use a 50-50 ratio. And so the 50% of that leaves us with a NOI I think that's 540. Yep. So we have a net of 540 a year. We got that so far. All right, let's go on to the next. So now we just want to determine the value. Well, that's easy. You just determine that by the cap rate. So now we say 540K. Divide that, and because I'm in Cincinnati, and I'm gonna say this is a C-plus property, cap rate could drop a little more, but you know, 6.5 cap rate is a fair number. So we'll just say 6.5, divide that by 6.5, and that gives us a value of $8,307,692. But I'm gonna round it off to just $8.3 million. Right? So just a rough estimate, we believe that building's worth $8.3 million. Now we gotta work backwards. The thing is backwards is because how much can we pay for it? What's the margin? What do we think the person will accept? But my numbers were based on projected income. So this is what it could be worth. So let's say the purchase price, the guy agrees, purchase price agrees to $5 million, right? It's $5 million, and let's say it needs $15,000 of dorm renovations. So we'll just say reno with a V, and let's say 15K a door. What that equals? Is that 1.5? Yeah, that equals 1.5 million total in renovations. So all in, we're in this deal for $6.5 million. All right, and this is the current value if we can get it fixed up. So fixed up. So far, it looks like we got some room in there. I mean, overall, we have 8.3 minus 6.5. You could make $1.8 million. Let me ask you, is that worth it? I don't know, you have to, what you gotta consider is, what did you have to do to make that 1.8? Was $15,000 a door a lot of work for you? Was a little bit of work, a lot of work? Did it take a lot of time? Did you have to do a lot of permits? Did it take you 3 months? Did it take you 5 years? Those are the things you gotta consider if it's worth it. Now, the next thing is, we saw that we could have a profit of 1.8 million, but let's talk about the cash flow as well. So remember, we are gonna be all in for 6.5. Right, we're all in for 6.5. If you wanna go get a loan to cost, current rates are about 75% at 5%. Now, you probably can beat that. Some people are doing 3.5, maybe 4.5. I'm being conservative. I'm gonna say we're gonna have an interest rate at 5%. At 5% interest rate, amortized over 25 years, mostly commercial 20, but depending on your private banker. And you got 75% loan to cost, right? So what that means is if at 75% loan to cost, you're gonna have to bring a down payment of 1.675 $1.5 million to the table. So roughly 1.6. So it means your mortgage is going to be $4,875,000. All right, I'm rounding some numbers off. So now your mortgage is 4.875. All right. Now the debt on this at, you know, 5%, et cetera, your debt on annual debt on this will be $342,000 a year. Now remember earlier, I go back to the sheets, but I already remember NOI that it had was 540. Remember, this was the NOI. We'll square that up so you can see it. So your overall net income will be $198,000 a year. Now, you take the 198 over the 165, that gets you your average cash on cash per year. So that this comes out, well, you don't need that, to a 12.12, I'll just round it off, to a 12% cash on cash, and you can net over 1.8 million for this deal. So all you have to do is ask yourself, is it worth it? Now, if you got investors, you're gonna have to structure that deal for that. But if you're just doing a deal for yourself, make it 12%, cash on cash, 1.8, that's a great deal. Now, me, myself, I like to make a little more. I like home run deals. But this is a safe deal. I don't see how you're getting hurt, but you gotta be able to handle construction. Hey, but look, that's our time today. Stay tuned. Hey, you know what? If you wanna learn more about this, we talk about this every week on our live podcast from Broke to Millions Live, where we talk to our students, we talk to multiple people in the hotel and apartment industry, where you can learn all these different things, how to analyze deals, how to find deals, how to raise money, how to do money with no money down. Just join us every Thursday at 12 o'clock and we'll share you all this information. So join Facebook group Apartment Investing Secrets. God bless you, God keep you, may God bless you beyond your belief, but not your capacity. And remember, you're one big deal away. See you soon.